comes the axe. Prove yourself!
And it's Elder Dyson Siler. So, Assumption on Fate Deal, and that's gonna be Fate Bien Vicky. Time in for E-Home. Innocence slow him down now with his Caustic Finale, waiting for his time to do a burst strike. He get burst, and that's a burst strike and a thunder strike combo. Ooh! Fate Bien Vicky hit him. That is. Sorry, I missed the actions on top. Going in for Fate Bien Vicky. Hit him. Back to the bottom is Freeze. Good news for Team E-Home because they really need to win this game. Oh, glimpse him back into the burst strike of that Sand King. And Fate Bien need to be careful. He got a high bounty on himself as he has 2 kills and quite high level. Juggernaut! Sila spinning around and go for Facebook and maybe a Belt Fury. Yang on the bomb lane and getting surrounded by a lot of E-Home players. He might have to do the Rabbit in order to kill someone before he died. But yeah, he deals the most damage and died. You are at low HP, like when you are in the red zone, you must know your limit of the hero. Like, burst strike in, a cut. Slow down that Rubik, spinning around at the Siler. And yep, got it. So that he could push fast. I think that's the main objective of this kind of lineup. They have the Track and the Dragonite in the same team. That's the kill. Once again, Flim for the second time, and it's still the same guy. Ravage this time comes out and hits all of them, running away for that Dragonite. Telekinesis, do you even lift on the high ground? And was stunned by the Dragon Tail. Can he get away? He doesn't have anything to defend himself. That's why he goes down for that Siler. That's the first big team fight for both teams. And it ends with E-Home victory, I believe. Freeze. Gotta get away from that Soul Assumption. He doesn't have any backup. Not sure why is he there. A very easy kill by him. Top lane, Avalanche and Toss on that Sand King. He does the Toss, but he's gonna get hit by the tree. Down to 4. VJ Thunder. Yang might have to come in front in order to take the damage for his teammates. He pop up the pipe. Echo Storm just gonna hit on that Latrak and aiming on the Latrak first. The main damage falls down and follow up with the Earth Splitter. Yang keep his he already used his Rabbit, but just not gonna help anything on that. And then that's it. Old Chicken on killing spree, a double kill for him. They also got that Disruptor. Dominating. Now he might get caught. A very nice copy paste Reno, the tight hunted Ravage, and use it on the hard. Top tower is under attack. Burrow swag on that Rubik. And then follow up with a splintered everything for the Rubik. Rubik. It's quite tanky because of the new feel, I think. His new field is still level 2. Imagine if it's level 4. E-Home him. Yang about to get caught by the Dragonite. Dragonite, Avalanche Torch, and everything on that Tidehunter. Does he have a Rabbit? He has. But where is the support? It doesn't. Nike ahead. That was a big lead. Dragonite is very strong right now with the Chao Blade and Sentinel Yasha. They're gonna grab this opportunity to end the game. Dino. That's what I'm talking about. 2 slash, 3-4 slash, and Omni slash just enough to kill and end the damage for his teammate until his support comes in. But it would be hard to fight without that Echo Storm. So it's gonna be the date of the Dragonite as well. That is what we was exposed. Not that exposed though. Setting up the chaotic field for DDC, trying to go on the high ground, but he still get rid by that Dragonite anyway. Dragonite jump over the chaotic field. Next one gonna be a Sand King with a Soul Assumption double kill. Don't wanna buy back. They surely lose this one. Dragonite is inside and look at that. Oh no, Ravage comes in. But anyone, Tiny is very, very tanky. Elder Titan tanky and also Dragonite. Now finally a Ravage coming out from that Rubick. Seems to be a better Ravage from that that Tide Hunter though. Finally an Omni Slash comes out. Burrow Strike on one, they may be able to defend the last set of the Range Rag. Spinning around, Blade Fury going on the Disruptor, gives him back. No, I'm sorry, I mean the Elder Titan. The Elder Titan trying to pick up the gem, and he's running away. Echo Storm might save him alive for a while. Scylla finish off the He Home Innocent, Tower Tier 4 shooting on him. He's just gonna go straight and find some place to buy a buy. Oh, that's it. The Omni Slash first skills. He see the target already. Barrel Strike inside. Here we go. Strike on at them. Finally, Omni Slash comes in with the Earth Spitter. He dodged that as well. Now he comes out. He's still got an edge. He's spinning around. He will be safe from all the damage of the spells. Start slashing on the Dragonite. Dragonite gets slashed on the backhand side. And that's going to be a Rabbit trying to get away. Dragonite is so tanky, but the one who's about to go down is actually Tiny. No more Tiny. Now he's outnumbered. Dragonite getting outnumbered by TVJ Thunder, a stun on him, coming back full HP, full mana. Dragonite need to run away, even though he's on the Elder Dragon form, he gets glimpsed back into the circle. Dragonite, where's he gonna go? Split turn comes out with a finish him with a Burrow Strike, and he's just gonna go forward, ready to do some doubling inning. They're just gonna push, really, really gonna push. Tiny bot back, it's time to go back, maybe a Burrow Strike on that Rubick, they got another kill, and it's time to go back, really. Important anymore. Now let's take a look in the middle. They start a team fight. Pop the Black King bar goes in first, but a Tiny. Tiny, where is Juggernaut? Here comes a Ravage and the Earth Splitter at the same time, and they lost a Dragonite. This is not doing good. They lost a Dragonite with no buyback in front of their base. And risky to lose the Barracks right there. A double kill by Scylla. That is just like what I am. I a Nostradamus or something? I kind of deja vu that this kind of thing happened. Even
set of racks, definitely.
Now here go, Burrow Strike inside, and that's another mistake made by Innocent. He's already get glimpsed back into Kinetic Field. They made a lot of mistakes in the late game team for Team E-Home. Coming in, die one by one, and no buyback for Tiny. They just got that Dragonite back. Now they lost Tiny. It's time to go in for all of them. Dragonite doesn't have an Elder Dragon form. It's gonna be hard for him to fight that Samurai Juggernaut. Where is him? Earth Splitter gonna deal a lot of damage, and they lost that Sand King. Next one gonna be the Tide Hunter. The Razor's gonna retreat. Finding already, it's gonna be that Rubick. If you kill Rubick first, that's no copy paste arena on the Ravage. And Rubick still survived though. However, the first one who goes out is actually Scylla. This is not looking good. Scylla bought back right away. Burrow Strike order to get away from that Tiny. Stuck in a circle. It's gonna take field standing storm. It's gonna kill everyone. E-home him outside the circle. But he's trying to save the Dragonite. The Star Dragonite is still alive. Where is Juggernaut? He might get kited. Now the game tie changing, 1, 2, 3, 4. Here we go, and that's gonna be an Omni Slash. Where are you gonna go? So Assumption's already gonna get slashed down. That fake Bian Ricky, where you gonna go spinning around like a milkshake. My milkshake brings all the boy to the yard, and where is him? DDC in front of that Dragonite, that he should not fight Dragonite alone as he is a support setting up the Celtic field. Lock him down, where is the main damage dealer? We need Juggernaut here, just like we need a police when something bad happens. Juggernaut comes in, just gonna take down that Dragonite. We're gonna go with slow down, but another dragon, that's insane. Killing spree, no more buyback for that Juggernaut.